Welcome to the viewers for the lecture in the subject structural analysis. Now this is lecture number 111, in which we will continue one more problem on the analysis of redundant trusses. So far we have taken two problems in which we have concentrated on member forces, that is in the case of trusses having redundant members. Now here we will take up the analysis of trusses with a lack of fit and also temperature cases. So the procedure for both is same. So let us first discuss the general concept and then we will discuss one numerical example. So the analysis procedure for structures subjected to lack of fit and also structures subjected to temperature changes, both are same, procedure is same. Therefore we will discuss one numerical example that will serve the whole purpose. Right, now already we have discussed that the strain energy U equal to integral F square dx by 2ae, F square dx by 2ae. So from this, on integration, this F square into dx will become L on integration, and dou u by dou t will become sigma I equal to 1 to n F into dou f by dou t into L by ae. That is equal to 0 because the displacement along the redundant member is equal to 0. So we normally find out the degree of redundancy, remove the redundant member to make the structure statically determinate, apply tensile force T along the redundant member one at a time. Of course, we have discussed only problems with static indeterminacy only so far, and dou f by dou t etc. will give you that is equal to 0, that is the displacement along the redundant member is equal to 0. Right, so this is what we have discussed earlier. Right, now we will take up two cases. One is structures with lack of fit and structures subjected to temperature change. That is, that during the fabrication of a truss, a particular member or members may be little excess in length or having a little shortage in length. Say, a diagonal member, if you want to fit a diagonal member or horizontal member or vertical member, whatever it may be, during the fabrication, if a particular member is say 5 mm longer or 5 mm shorter, like that, we cannot go for one more member. What we do is, if the member is short in length, we extend it, apply a tensile force and fit it in position. If it is excess, so 5 mm or 6 mm or 7 mm longer, then we just compress it and fit it in its position. So this already we have discussed. So this is what is called lack of fit. So when it is little shorter or little longer, we cannot fix the member as in the case of other members having exact length. Therefore, when you apply a tensile force and fix the member in position, or when you apply a compressive force and fix the member in position, that itself will cause force in all other members. If it is a statically determinate truss, there is no problem, that will adjust. But in the case of statically indeterminate trusses, when there is a lack of fit, then that itself will cause stress in all other members. We are applying a tensile force or compressive force to fit the member in its position. Therefore, that will cause force in all other members. So in that case, in the place of zero, you get a plus or minus delta, where we apply 0, it will be plus or minus delta. Now this delta is the shortage or excess in length of the redundant member. So if the member is shorter, then what is required? We have to apply a tensile force to fix it in position. So you have to make use of plus sign. If the member is longer, then you have to compress it. You have to compress the member and then fix it in position. So for which you have to use minus sign. So plus sign when the member is shorter, minus sign when the member is longer. Other than this, the analysis procedure is same as we have done. So suppose if one member is having lack of fit, you remove that member, that treat that member as a redundant member, remove that member, right, and apply a tensile force along the direction of the redundant member and analyze for the force in various members using method of joints. So the force in all members will be in terms of T only. So the analysis procedure will be the same as we have discussed earlier. So which member is to be treated as redundant is important, that is the member having lack of fit, member having little extra length or little shortage in length, right, that is the redundant member. And so finally, in the place where you are supposed to use 0 in the earlier cases, now you have to use plus or minus delta. Plus delta if the member is shorter, minus delta when the member is longer. That's all. That is the only change. Otherwise, we are going to repeat the numerical example as we have discussed earlier. Right. Next case is that of temperature change. So that is also same. The procedure is same. Because when the member, if a particular member may be in contact with some medium causing temperature, or one or two members may be directly in contact with sunlight, or a particular member may be welded, which may be subjected to temperature change. So temperature, there may be temperature increase or temperature decrease. A particular member or members may be subjected to this thing, right? In that case, when it is subjected to change of temperature, when there is increase in the temperature, then we know that the change in length of the member is equal to L naught alpha T. L naught is the length of the member, alpha is the coefficient of linear expansion of the material of the member, and T is the temperature. If it is temperature increase, it will be having increase in length. If there is a temperature decrease, there will be a decrease in the length. Therefore, in the same formula which we discussed earlier, you can change the title here. So in the place of delta, you are going to make use of L naught alpha T. That's all. So here, plus or minus as before, L naught alpha T. That's all. Now, this we will be using if it is decrease in temperature. Decrease in temperature. Minus means it will be subjected to increase in temperature. When it is subject to increase in temperature, the member, yes, this is for increase in temperature. That's all. Otherwise, therefore, as far as stresses with the lack of fit or temperature is concerned, The formula is same. In the place of zero, you are going to make use of delta. If it is lack of it, it is delta. If it is temperature case, this delta is equal to L naught alpha T. That's all. If this is known, we will be able to solve all problems on these two topics. Therefore, we need not discuss number of problems. Therefore, I am going to discuss only one numerical example on this topic. That will cover all the cases. Temperature increase, temperature decrease, member having extra length, member having shortage in length, all these things will be covered. Only the number will be different and the procedure is same. Alright. We'll take up a cantilever truss. Hinged. Here it is hinged. This is the truss. No loading is given, so a particular member will be subjected to either lack of fit or temperature case. So this is 4 meters. A. This is the truss. No loading. So I will not write the problem, I will just read the problem. So determine the forces in all the members of the frame. So we have to find out the force in all the members of the frame shown in figure due to a fall in temperature of. So there is a fall in temperature. Temperature of 28 degree centigrade in member BC. In the member BC. Member BC is subjected to a drop in temperature of 28 degree centigrade. All the members have a cross-sectional area of, for all the members, a cross-sectional area, so need not get confused with this A, it is the area of cross-section, that is equal to 1300 mm square. All members have the cross-section area of 1300 mm square. The coefficient of linear expansion alpha equal to 0.000012 per degree centigrade. Per degree centigrade. And the value of E, that I will write it here, E equal to 2 × 10^5. Newton per mm square. So that's about the given data. You have to make use of the strain energy method. There is no external force, only one member is subjected to a drop in the temperature. What are the forces in the various members of the truss? So we know that we have to first find out the degree of static interdependency, the degree of degree of static indeterminacy equal to. Now this truss starts from a rigid base. Rigid base. That is, it starts from a fixed base. So this is not a member. This one is not a member. This is the fixed support. Fixed support. Therefore, AB is not a member here. Right. In the earlier case also, we have discussed a truss in which there was a member. Here it was pin jointed. Here it was pin jointed, and here it was roller support. So here it is. It was a hinged support, and here it was a roller support. So in this case, this was a member. Now here it is different. You have to understand the difference between the earlier problem 110 and 111. That is a difference. That one has to be. Now this is a member. This is a member. Now here this is not a member, right? Right. Static indeterminacy, when the stress starts from a rigid base, it is M minus 2J, that's all. M minus 2J. It is not M minus 2J minus 3. No. Right. Now here, M equal to, there are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 members. There are 7 members. Minus 2 into joints. Joints. Pin joints, pin joints, here it is 1, 2 and 3. These are the pin joints. So 2 into 3 equal to 1, equal to 1. So the structure is statically indeterminate to 1 degree. So that is 1 degree, right? Now, we have to treat the member having temperature change, namely member BC will be treated as the redundant. The member having temperature change will be treated as a redundant. Therefore, for analyzing this stress, you treat the member BC as redundant. So this is what is the given stress. Now we are just removing the member BC for making the stress statically determinate. So that is the first work to be done. Remove the redundant member. Redundant member. And then in the strain energy method, we have to apply a force T along the redundant member. A force both at the joint B and also at joint C. Apply a tensile force. A tensile force T. So assuming that T is the force in the member CB. Now we can start the analysis. Now in the case of a cantilever truss, we need not bother about the reactions as we have done earlier. Earlier there was a hinged support, roller support, etc., where we have got the reactions before starting the analysis. Now it's a cantilever truss. We can straight away start whether it is loaded, whether it is subjected to temperature change, whether it is having a lack of it, whatever may be the problem, we can straight away start the analysis from the free end. From the free end, having not more than 2 members. That is very important. Not more than 2 members. Suppose if there is a truss like this, there is a truss like this. We should not start from here because there will be 3 members. So we have to start from this point where there are only 2 members. So that point one has to understand. Where we have to start? We have to start from a joint having not more than 2 members. Right now here there are only 2 members, and since the length of this is 4 meters, the length of this is also 4 meters. So the angles will be 45 degrees. All angles. So this one, all these angles will be 45 degrees. All values will be 45 degrees. Right. Now we will start from joint E. Now joint E, we have got a horizontal member, we have got an inclined member. We have to mark all the details around joint E only. No external load at the point. So this angle is 45 degrees. So this is actually E. So we will assume the force to be tensile. So force in the member E, the other end is D. So for the diagonal member is C. So here also this will be assumed as tensile. This is force in the member EC. And of course with the vertical also the angle is 45 degrees. So we have to draw this using dotted line. By mistake you should not draw it as a full line because that will become another member. So we have to be very careful in drawing these lines. Right. Now here, suppose if you use sigma V equal to 0. There is no other force or no other reaction. So sigma V equal to 0 means FEC into cos of its angle with the vertical. So FEC into cos 45 plus. So this will not give any vertical component. This is a horizontal member. Cos 90 will be 0. And there is no other force. No other force. Therefore, this is equal to 0. Therefore, FEC equal to 0. FEC equal to 0. Right. Now, as we have discussed earlier, we will have a separate diagram for marking the forces that we get from the analysis. C, E, D, this is fixed, right. Now we have got FEC equal to 0, so that means this is a dummy member, right. Then sigma H equal to 0 gives FED, it is towards left. And plus FEC into its angle with the horizontal. Its angle with the horizontal is also 45 degrees. Cos 45. Right? These are the only two quantities. So the sum is equal to 0. Equal to 0. And FEC is already 0. Therefore, FED is also equal to 0. Therefore, FED, this is also 0. This is also a dummy member. So that is about the two members meeting at the joint E. Now we have to choose the next joint. Next, there are two joints. One is joint C, the other one is joint D. Now, suppose if you want to choose joint D, this is 0. This already we have got it. This already we have got it. Right. Now, there are three unknowns, namely DC, DA, and DB. So, next, therefore, D is not the right size. We cannot solve because there are two equations, sigma V equals 0, sigma H equals 0, but there are three members. So with the two equations, we cannot solve three members. Therefore, next member D is not possible. Suppose we take C. Now, this force is known, zero. So, known. This is an unknown force. It is, but it is T. It is T. This is a force now, a force. So we have got only two members. Member CD and member CA. There are two unknowns only. Therefore, we will choose joint C. So, joint C, we have got a vertical member. This is C. We will assume this to be tensile. FC, the opposite end is D. So FCD, then there is inclined member here. So this value equal to 0. This is a CE, FCE, that is 0. Then there is an inclined force here whose value is T. So this angle, all values are 45 degrees. So we have to draw a bigger diagram so that you can mark the details without congestion. Otherwise, you can understand when we draw a small sketch, all these values will merge with each other, will not be able to distinguish the value. So better is just draw a bigger diagram so that you will be able to mark details clearly. Right. Now here, there is another horizontal member. Another horizontal member. Member is CA. That also we will take it as tensile. FCA. C is an near end and A is the opposite end. Opposite end of the member. Right. So this angle is also 45 degrees. This angle is also 45 degrees. Right. Now we have marked all the details. There is no other force. We have marked all the details around joint C. We have completely marked here. Right. Now, there are two unknowns. FCD is one unknown and FCA is another unknown. FCA. Right. Now, we can choose anything. Sigma V equal to 0 or sigma H equal to 0. Let us say sigma V equal to 0. Sigma V equal to 0 gives, sigma V equal to 0 gives, FCE, that value is 0. This value is 0. 0 into cos 45. That you can just forget about it. Then, plus FCD. That itself is vertically downwards. Then, this will cause a vertical component. So, this into cos of its angle with vertical 45 degrees. Therefore, plus T, that is also going to cause only a downward component. So, T into cos of its angle with vertical, so that is also downward. Right. Now, the fourth member is this member. So, this into cos 90 will become 0. Therefore, FCA will not give any vertical component. Therefore, the sum of these things is equal to 0. Therefore, FCD equal to minus T into cos 45. Cos 45 equal to 0.707. T into 0.707. Therefore, FCD equal to, this is equal to minus 0.707 T or equal to 0.707 T compressive. So this is FCD. Now take it to the figure. FCD is compressive. So FCD is compressive. Therefore, this is towards the joint. Mark it towards the joint. So this is FCD. This is equal to 0.707T. Right. Now next is sigma H equal to 0. Sigma H equal to 0 gives FCA, this is towards left, and plus this is the horizontal component, this will be 0, horizontal component of FCA is 0, and we have this one, T into cos 40, that is also towards left. Therefore, plus T into cos 45 equal to 0. This is also towards left. Therefore, FCA equal to minus T into 0.707. So, FCA equal to minus 0.707 T, or it is compressive. This is also compressive. because it is minus. Therefore, this is also compressive, mark it towards the joint. The arrows will be towards the joint. This is also 0.707T. 0.707T. So that is over. So next we will take joint D. We will mark all the details around joint D. Joint D. Joint D. So here at joint D, we have a, so this is joint D. There is a member to the right whose value is equal to 0. There is a member to the left. Let us assume this to be tensile. So F D, the opposite end is B. So F D B. Then there is a vertical member in which already we have the force. It is compressive, 0.707T. So this force is known, compressive, 0.707T. Then there is another inclined member. Inclined member at 45 degrees. 15 minutes after. So it is DA. FDA. FDA. So FDA, this is this member. This member. So these are the four members. Four members. There is no other force. We have marked all the details around joint D. We have completed. Now, this angle is 45 degrees. This angle is also 45 degrees. 45 degrees. Right. Now, the unknown here is, there are two unknowns actually. FDA is unknown and FDB is also unknown. Right. Now, we can choose sigma V equals 0 or sigma H equals 0. But when we first choose sigma H equals 0, H equals 0, this will have a horizontal component. Already there is a horizontal force. So, you will get only an equation in terms of FDA or FD and FDB. Nothing wrong. You will get an equation. It will be solved in the next step. Or, first if you choose sigma V equal to 0, sigma V equal to 0 gives, you will get the value of FDA. This will not interfere. FDB will not come into the picture. So, you can straight away get the value of FDA. But both are correct. Procedure wise, both are correct. So, sigma V equals 0 gives, this is FDA into cos of its angle with vertical. Cos of its angle with vertical is this thing. So, this is in the upward direction. Then, minus downward, minus 0.707T, because this is downwards. Right. So, both are, that is in the vertical direction. So, this will not give any vertical component. This also will not give any vertical component. Only these are the two values equal to 0. Therefore, FDA into 0.707 equal to 0.707T. Or, you will find this 0.707 will get cancelled. Therefore, FDA equal to T, tensile force. FDA equal to T. You are getting with the plus sign. Therefore, it is tensile. therefore immediately mark it here. This is actually B, this is A, right. FDA means this is tensile. So tensile away from the joint, and here also we can mark it away from the joint. So this is T, this is T, right. And next, sigma, so we will get the value straight away like this, then sigma H equals 0 gives FDA, 1 is 0, this value is 0, then plus FDB, plus FDB. So there is no need for any sign convention as we have discussed earlier. When the values towards left is assumed as positive, whatever is in the opposite direction, mark it with a negative sign. So there is no need for any particular sign convention. If our calculations are systematic, that will solve our problem. FDA. FDA into its horizontal component will be equal to FDA into cos of its angle with the horizontal, that is cos 45 degrees. Cos 45. So, and this vertical force will not give any horizontal component. We can forget about this. So, coming to horizontal, one is 0, one is FDB, and horizontal component of FDA, that's all. Equal to 0. Equal to 0. Therefore, FDB equal to FDB equal to FDA is already T. FDA is already T. Therefore, minus. When this is taken to the right hand side, it is minus T into cos 45 degree. Or FDB equal to minus 0.707T. Or this is compressive. This is also compressive. Compressive. Therefore, FDB is compressive. Therefore, mark it towards the joint. It is compressive. 0.707T. And this is already tensile. We have started only from here. This is tensile. And this is tensile. This is the force that you assumed. Only based on that assumption, we have done the complete analysis. And of course, we have completed everything because AB is not a member. AB is a fixed support. It is not a member. Therefore, that completes the analysis for the force F in all the members. So, marking the angles with both vertical and horizontal and using only cos theta will solve part of the problem. And drawing a separate diagram like this for the force, marking the force that you are getting from the analysis will solve another part of the, because if you are not drawing the separate diagram, then the forces will be somewhere. You will be getting it with a minus sign, and the next step you will have with a plus sign. We will be confused whether to use minus sign or plus sign. All those things will be there. Therefore, if we mark the forces in a separate diagram, that will help us in the final tabulation to a great extent. Right. So now we know serial number, member, then force F, let us say kilonewton, F, then dou F by dou T, as per the formula, dou F by dou T, because we know it is sigma F into dou F by dou T, for which, so one column for this, one column for this, L values are different, therefore you must have one column for L, right. Then by AE, area is given to be same for all the members. If the areas are different, then we have to form one column, provide one column for area. Here, area of all members are all equal to 1300 mm². Young's modulus is same for all members. Therefore, we need not unnecessarily include A and E in the tabulation, multiply or divide every value by A and E. We need not waste our time. That we can delete at the end. Right. Therefore, AE, when A and E are same, we need not bother about those things. Therefore, next column is F into dou F by dou T into L. And of course, final force, we'll have one more column. That will do it later. Right. And here, better always to provide rows and columns clearly, because many students are used to observe, they do it without opening out the tabulation, because the values will overlap, there will be a lot of confusion. So to avoid that, you just draw a clear tabulation. This six, seven. There are seven members. You have to provide seven rows. All this uniformity has to be adjusted. Here it is not uniform. So particularly when you do in the second part of the paper, you have to adjust the spacing, because below this table you have to provide one sum, a column. So these things can be adjusted, and you can do the calculations systematically only when you open out the tabulation clearly. Because I used to observe many students doing without this tabulation. So this you can have a wider column, and this will have only one value, L. That depends upon whether you're going to make use of the length in terms of meter or millimeter, because our Young's modulus is Newton per mm². Force we have assumed as a kilonewton. Therefore, area in terms of millimeter square. Therefore, it is better to use this also in terms of millimeter. So that millimeter, 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 that will be better. But only thing is, this is in terms of kilonewton, this is in terms of newton. We will discuss that when we substitute the values. Right. Now, serial number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 members. Now, 7 members, AC, the top card member, it is AC. Then CE, then ED, DB, ED, DB, BC, AD, and CD. This covers all the members of the truss. Now AC, it is compressive, 0.707, compressive means minus, minus 0.707T. If the figure is not there, you have to search in the, your calculation might run for two pages or three pages. You have to search for the values. Now everything is readily available. Because it is compressive, it is minus. CE, it is zero. So you need not search. It is readily available. ED, it is zero. Then DB is again compressive. Therefore, minus 0.707T. Then BC is tensile, that is the redundant member, BC, tensile, right. Then AD is tensile, that is also T. BC is BC is tensile, that is our redundant member. Then AD is also tensile. AD is also tensile. Then CD, this value. This value is also compressive, minus 0.707. Therefore, including the redundant member, for all the members, we have to provide the tabulation. That is why in the formula, it is given as sigma 1 to n. All the members you have to include. All the members. Right. So, once if this is correctly transferred, then dou f by dou t will be minus 0.707. Partially differentiating with respect to t. This is 0. This is 0. This is minus 0.707. So, this is 1. This is also 1. Minus 0.707. Right. Coming to the length of the members, we are going to make use of millimeter. Right. Millimeter. So, the member AC is a horizontal member. Therefore, this is 4000. 4 meters. 4000. Next is the diagonal member. It is 5657. Root of 4 square plus 4 square. That will give you the length of the diagonal member. And next is horizontal member. Horizontal, that is ED is horizontal. DB is also horizontal. DB is horizontal. Then member BC. BC is a diagonal member. So it is 5657. AD is also diagonal. AD is also diagonal. That is also 5657. And CD is a vertical member. That is 4000. So these are the values. Right. Now, F is this value. Dou F by dou T is this value. And this is this value. F into dou F by dou T into L equal to 1999.4 t. Actually, we have rounded this 0.707. Suppose if three more digits are added, this will become 2000. Anyway, no problem. So, next is that of 0, because this is 0. Therefore, this is 0. And again, it is 1999.4 t, because here there is one minus, here also there is minus, that will become plus. On multiplication, that will become plus. So 5657 t. 5657 t, because this is t, this is 1, 5657 t. So this is also 5657 t. And here it is 1999.4. So, we have to give space, because we are going to write the sum of the values here. We have to give some space for this. I will rub off this. Right. Now, coming to this formula, now we are going to make use of only this, that is dou u by dou t equal to 1 to n f into dou f by dou t into l by ae is equal to, here in this case it is plus or minus delta. Now this delta equal to L naught alpha T. Member is subjected to a drop in the temperature. So, drop in the temperature means you can use plus sign. Increase in the temperature means you have to use minus sign. So, here delta equal to L naught alpha T. So, L naught alpha T equal to the diagonal member. Member BC is the redundant. Right. For member BC, L naught equal to 5657, alpha equal to 28 degrees centigrade, alpha equal to 28 degrees centigrade, and the coefficient of linear expansion equal to 0.000012. So the left hand, so this value will be 1.98, the right hand side will be equal to 1.98. Now coming to the left hand side, the sum of all these values will be equal to 17312. 17312.3t. The sum of all these values. All these values equal to. Therefore, left hand side it is 17312.3t by L by AE. So this we have written, this we have got in the tabulation by AE. Area for all the members equal to 1300 mm square, and Young's modulus is equal to 2 into 10 power 5. So this is in terms of millimeter. Therefore, here this is in terms of newtons, this is in terms of kilonewton. So multiply by 1000. This 1000 will make the kilonewton as newton, or newton per mm square as kilonewton per millimeter. So the meaning of this you have to understand. So this is either to convert kilonewton to newton, or this newton per mm square to kilonewton per square. So that value, Lord. So on solving this, we get T equal to 28.53 kilonewton. So that means it is tensile. The force is tensile itself. Tensile. So 28.53 is the value of the redundant force. We are getting with the plus sign. Therefore, that member is under tension, because naturally when the member is subjected to drop in temperature, that will be trying to shrink, that will be prevented. You have to apply tension. So naturally it is plus. So 28.53. Then for getting the final force, so this is the force in the redundant member. So this is the force in the member BC. Force in the member BC equal to this value. Right. And once we get the value of the redundant force, then all forces we can obtain, because the force member AC equal to minus 0.707T. So minus 0.707 into 28.53. That value equal to minus 20.17. So this is in terms of kilonewton. These are the final forces. Final force. And this member diagonal, dummy member, minus 28.53, and this is minus 20.17. So these are mere substitution only, and that will give the, that support the final force in various members. So we can draw another diagram showing the final values of force in all members. One horizontal, one diagonal. Horizontal. This is A, C, E, D, B. So the force in the member AC is minus 20.17. That means it is compressive 20.17 kilonewton. This is zero. And the member DB is also compressive. Therefore, this is also 20.17 compressive. 20.17 kilonewton, and the diagonal members are values are T. So that means a tensile 28.53. This is also tensile at 28.53 kilonewton, and for the vertical member CD that is also compressive. 20.1 is also compressive, means arrows towards the joint. This is also 20.17 kN. So these are the final forces. So that completes this analysis. So on the same lines, whether it is subjected to rise in temperature or fall in temperature or having lack of it, member may be little extra in length or little short in length, for all problems this is the procedure, as long as the degree of indeterminacy is 1. So far we have discussed only problems with the static indeterminacy equal to 1. So whether it is external indeterminacy or internal indeterminacy, so you have to make that as redundant, remove it, make the structure statically determinate, and I think this one problem will be sufficient for doing any problem on trusses having lack of fit in members or trusses in which member or members are subjected to rise or fall in temperature. Of course, this will be useful only for 1 degree of redundancy. For 2, the procedure is slightly different. The equations are slightly different. Right? I think that will satisfy the requirement of the viewers for doing problems on trusses by strain energy method. Right? Thank you. Thank you for your cooperation.